Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. One of the greatest acts of photobombing in cosmic history will occur on April 8th, when the total solar eclipse sweeps across North America. Tens of millions of people will look up as the moon passes in front of the sun. However, a few people, including an untold number of astronomers, will be glancing off to the side when the Devil Comet races across the skies. The Devil Comet's latest closest approach to the sun occurred in 1954. The comet's appearance at the time established it as a celestial superstar. Its arrival during this month's eclipse will make it something of a cosmic undercard, but that doesn't mean it isn't a striking celestial body. The comet, which was discovered by French astronomer Jean-Louis Pons in 1812 and verified by American astronomer William Brooks on a subsequent flyby in 1883, is quite large, measuring 17 kilometers in diameter. In contrast, the asteroid that wiped off the dinosaurs is estimated to have been 10 kilometers in size. Despite its enormous size, the comet presents no harm to us. At its closest approach to Earth on June 2nd, it will be 232 million kilometers away. That is substantially greater than the Earth's 150 million kilometer distance from the Sun. The comet's truly hellish name stems from its unusual look. It is referred to as a cryovolcanic object because its frozen surface occasionally bursts in response to solar heating. Last July, one such explosion occurred, causing the comet to emit a forked tail. The twin streaks give the comet the appearance of devil's horns. That description is ancient, but modern skywatchers refer to it as the Millennium Falcon comet because it resembles Han Solo's iconic spacecraft. The comet will brighten slightly as it approaches the sun, and it should be visible to the unaided eye low in the west about an hour after sunset in the northern hemisphere. You should choose a position distant from city lights and with a clear view of the western horizon. Binoculars are recommended, as the comet may be difficult to locate without them. When the eclipse causes the sun to darken, the comet would be located about 25 degrees away from the eclipse sun. The comet should be fairly easy to find during the total solar eclipse, as well as several planets, but the main focus during those 4 minutes should be on the eclipse itself. As another total solar eclipse, by contrast, won't return to the 48 contiguous states until 2044. That's it for today's video. Stay safe and healthy.